Hey guys, it's Rishi2107. Today I'll be showing you the latest Jelly Bean build of Cyanogen mod, that is 10.1. So without further ado, let's begin. The first thing that you will need is to install the SafeStep app. As usual, I have installed it already. Let's get to the next point. Open the app and click install recovery. I have also installed it, so I need not do it again. So after you've done these two steps, just power off your device. Power it on again. Next thing you need to do is hit the menu key. After you're seeing this screen, just hit the menu key. You will be greeted with this menu. So after this, just go into boot options, select ROM slot 1. Now for the sake of the tutorial and to make it quick, I'm selecting 1 GB. Okay, and create a ROM slot. Now you should not be getting this error, that is failed to mount external storage using the internal storage. Now the problem with this, that is it is showing, is I have not kept a SD card inside it. So the SD card slot of the Razer currently empty, as you can see. So that's why it is saying that it will be installing it into internal memory. Don't worry about it, it's not an issue. Just create a ROM slot. Now before you do this setup and all these things, you need to, as usual, download the files in the description. The links are as usual in the description, so download them and keep them in your memory card or your internal memory. As for my case, I have kept it in my internal memory. So as soon as I finish this installing, creating a ROM slot, we'll be doing that. Now the main thing about Cyanogen mod is it is really fast and there are nightlies available. That means you get every update to whatever the devs are preparing every night. So whatever the changes that are there, you can update to it daily or rather nightly. Okay, so now we have completed the ROM slot creation. Just hit the back button, go to install and just select the zip file that you have downloaded from the link. Now I've kept it in my internal memory, so I'll just select. So there it is, CM 10.1, and as far as this is 2nd of April, so the nightly is of 2nd April, so I'll just select it and just confirm to flash. This takes about 1 minute or less than it, so just be patient. Okay, after this is done, just clear the cache and Dalvik. You can do it twice just to be sure. Back. Just hit the back button then. Now we have to install the G apps, that is the Google apps. So I'll just get a one level up and select this file. This is the latest Google apps for 4.2.2. So I'll select them and just confirm the flash. Okay, better installing the Google apps also. So we'll just clear the cache and Dalvik again just to be safe. And once more, I generally follow this two-step rule. So after that, you just go back, hit back, go to reboot and power off your device. Now after you've done that, just start your device. And in this splash screen, you have to select the search button, that is skip to continue, because we obviously want to skip the recovery. So after you see this, just hit search button. The first boot up as usual takes a lot of time, so please be patient. And there you go guys, the CyanogenMod boot animation. It's really awesome. You should seriously see this in person, because I love this boot animation. There's one more boot animation that I love, that is the AOKP, but we'll see it in the next video. As of for now, let's try this booting up. Now I have been busy with my university exams and they are not yet done, but I had a break for 2 days, so I thought you guys might like this update of Jellybean 4.2.2, that is CyanogenMod 10.1. So I took out some time out of my busy schedule of my exams and making this video for you. I hope you like it. Do subscribe if you're not already. Let's see what the CyanogenMod as for us. Okay, there it is, the CyanogenMod 10.1. Now I just fast forward this process so it need not bore you guys. So let's go. So the setup is almost done, let's hit finish. There you go guys, CyanogenMod 10.1. It is really smooth and as usual, the single finger and the double finger. So let's get into the app drawer. I recommend you to see and install this ROM, because I love it and I hope you guys also will love it. So let's go into the settings and find out what actual the version number is. So as you can see, it is Android 4.2.2. There you go, the Jellybean. Probably. So let's go now. So this is the app. This is where I just start some apps. So let's see the snappiness of it. So there you go. So now we'll just see. So to close it, as usual, you can do this or you can just click here and it will auto close it. I love that animation. Next thing is if you just pull it to one side, that will show you notifications. Right now I don't have any, but you can see them. The next thing is the two fingers scrolling. You need to with the two fingers. You will see this quick toggles. This is the data, the Bluetooth, the airplane mode, etc. And this is quite snappy performance. And as the main features of CyanogenMod is the most particular thing that I like about CyanogenMod is you just go into the about form and just see here the CyanogenMod updates. Now you can just select all versions including 90s. Okay. And it will check for it. So now currently I am installed the recent one. Now if tomorrow one more nightly comes, I will be greeted with this update. So this is the best thing that I feel about the CyanogenMod, and it will notify you accordingly on manually every boot, etc, etc. So let's get back now. And this is quite snappy performance, I must say. Now the interface that we have, special features are limited to this area, the CyanogenMod features, the launcher, the home screen, everything is customizable in this, including from transition effects to indicator positions and everything, the hidden apps, orientation, everything is in there. The dock, general settings, full screen, auto rotate, everything is in there. Next thing is the lock screen. The lock screen in 4.2.2 is very special. I'll tell you why in a single, in a second of moments. Let's go and just roam over here. So this is the lock screen settings, as you can see. Next thing comes the themes. Now you can download many themes from the Android market, or you can download it via some website that you might see. And you can just swipe and select whatever theme you want. If it is the AOKP theme, you can apply that. If it is CM19 that you like, you can apply that. That's a really good feature. Next is the system settings. Now in this there is too much of settings like system. You can like set the AM, PM, and style of battery, like the percentage, text, notification, now everything is there. Then the clock limit. There's a weather panel also, so everything out in here is customizable. I have been saying this for a long time, and once you download this and experience this, you will get the idea of how customizable this is. The next thing that I really want to show you is the profiles. Now in this you can add some profiles, and according to that you can add application groups. Now I will be making some video for that, and features of 4.2.2 some days after my exams are over. But let's keep it to that it is an awesome feature. And profile means it will customize exactly what you need at the time, what you want. So we'll just talk about it later. Now the next thing is the super user. Super user is already integrated into this ROM, so you don't need to download any super user app per se. Next thing is the accessibility. Now I have already made a video to show you how to enable the developer options, but you can just go into about home and just tap this build number, and you will see that you have enabled the development settings. Now if you just go back, you get developer options and performance. The developer options, the things that you use in this is the Android debugging for apps like Titanium Backup, etc, etc. You will be needing this quite a lot. Next thing it comes to performance. Performance, you can choose the CPU governor, that is hot plug, on demand, user, on interactive, whatever that you like. Next thing is the magnet. If you, as and when you decrease the frequency, your battery backup will boost terribly. So if I think you don't need that much power, I can like just go it to 800 megahertz. It will still be there. It will be good. Memory management, I recommend you not messing with this feature, because if you just mess with it, the ROM might reboot several times if you load too many apps. So just don't mess with it. The IO scheduler, you can just keep it. That's it. Better graphic performance but lower, you can just enable this also. It will like cause better graphic performance, but the quality will be lower. Now for apps that don't necessarily require quality of the graphics, you can use this. So just these are the features that just now on also on the frequency of about 800 MHz, this is a really snappy performance. As you can see, there is no lag whatsoever. So this is the camera, the phone dialer. Now you can see how fast this is booting up. Now I just do this. So these are the applications, and you can just see how it does it quite good. No issues at all. This performance is really good. So this was the short review of the CM10.1, that is the Jelly Bean 4.2.2. We'll be making a short app review for it. For that time, please subscribe, please comment, please share, please like the video. If you share this video among your friends, they might also get some help. So let's see. Thank you for checking out, guys. This was Rishi21007 checking you out. See ya in my next video.